Welcome to Grants Administration Take 5, the how, what, and when of an NIH grants administration topic in 5 minutes or less. This segment highlights funding opportunities advertised as Notices of Special Interest, or NOSIs. What's a NOSI? A Notice of Special Interest is a quick and efficient way to highlight an area of science we're looking to fund. They rely on existing, approved funding opportunity announcements, often parent announcements, for administrative information, including the details of how to apply. NOSIs allow the initial focus of the applicant community to be where it belongs, on the science. Let's step back and provide some background and context. Most of what NIH funds are investigator-initiated ideas submitted to parent or program announcements that do not have associated set-aside funds. Parent announcements don't target a specific area of science. They simply provide the submission, review, and policy information common to all applications for a specific activity code, like our R01 research projects. NIH institutes and centers post additional program announcements that highlight a research area of interest, but are virtually identical to parent announcements in all other aspects. They even compete for the same general funds. In June 2019, we formalized and expanded the usage of NOSIs across all NIH institutes as a replacement going forward for many non-parent program announcements. We continue to issue program announcements that have set-aside funds or special receipt, referral, or review considerations, but reissues of other program announcements are now done as NOSIs. Where can you find these NOSIs? Notices of Special Interest are posted in the NIH Guide for Grants and Contracts. By default, NIH Guide searches return active funding opportunity announcements and notices that match any provided keywords and filters. And there are additional options to adjust the items searched. NOSIs are returned when searching funding opportunities or notices, so let's choose Active Funding Opportunities, which provides visibility to FOAs and NOSIs, but filters out other types of notices. Let's say, for example, you are looking for NIDDK R01 opportunities on nutrition. Enter the search term nutrition and use the filters on the left to refine your search, selecting NIDDK as the organization and R01 as the activity code. Our search results include both FOAs and NOSIs. We'll click on the title of the NOSI to open it and take a closer look. All NOSIs have a similar structure. The notice number is at the top. In the key date section, you'll find the first available due date and an expiration date. Note that all our standard policies related to due dates apply to NOSIs, including policies for late applications, system issues, and continuous submission. The related announcement section includes the FOAs used for application submission and any corrective notices. Next, you'll find the NIH institutes that participate on the NOSI. Note that this list may be different than what is listed on the FOAs used for submission. The purpose section is the heart of the NOSI. It identifies the opportunity goal and research topics of special interest. The application and submission information section contains any opportunity-specific instructions, including the FOAs used for submission. We previously noted that the NOSI has its own expiration date. NOSIs can remain active through multiple reissues of the FOAs they point to. You can use the listed FOAs as the starting point, but verify the FOA is still active and hasn't been reissued before starting your application. The instructions in the NOSI supersede instructions found in both the application guide and the FOA used for submission. When responding to a NOSI, you must enter the notice number in the Agency Routing Identifier field, Box 4B, of the SF-424 R&R form. This allows NIH to appropriately refer and track applications for the NOSI. Forgetting this step can have big consequences. You won't be considered under the NOSI initiative, and in some cases, your application may even be withdrawn, so don't forget to include that NOSI number. And finally, the NOSI finishes off with contact information. If you subscribe to the NIH Guide listserv, you'll receive a weekly email, usually sent Friday afternoon, summarizing the items posted throughout the week. The summary email has various sections, including a section dedicated to notices of special interest. For more information, check out our Understanding Funding Opportunities page and our Notices of Special Interest podcast. You'll find these resources on the grants.nih.gov website. We know you're busy. Thanks for taking 5 minutes with us to learn about funding opportunities posted as Notices of Special Interest.